Hello students, good evening. Today we will talk about last part of this chapter, that is oxidation and reduction reaction of chapter number 1. Now oxidation and reduction reaction, they are commonly known as redox reactions. Red comes from the word reduction and ox from the oxidation. Since both these reactions, oxidation and reduction, occur simultaneously, that's why they are joined together and are also known as redox reactions. A few very important terms to be discussed in it. Number one is oxidation. It's a process which involves gain of oxygen or loss of hydrogen. Whenever you see that any atom has gained oxygen or lost hydrogen, it's oxidation. Whereas the reverse one, that is loss of oxygen or gain of hydrogen, will tell us about reduction. And then is a redox reaction. Definition: reduction and oxidation reaction always occur together, hence they are redox reaction. Another very important term which will come here in this chapter is oxidizing agent. It is a substance which gives oxygen or gain hydrogen. So any substance which can give oxygen to another substance in the reactant part is known as oxidizing agent. This means that oxidizing agent is also a reactant, and it gives, provide oxygen to the another reactant, that's an oxidizing agent. Whereas reducing agent, it is a substance which gives hydrogen or gain oxygen. So reducing agent is the one which gain, which takes oxygen from the another reactant. So it is also an reactant. Reducing agent or oxidizing agent, both are reactant. Oxidizing agent always gives, provide oxygen to the another reactant. Whereas reducing agent always accept oxygen from the other on another reactant. Whereas if we talk about a hydrogen part, oxidizing agent always receives hydrogen from the another reactant, whereas reducing agent always gives hydrogen to the another reactant. That's why their definition now is, it is a substance which gives oxygen or gain hydrogen, and reducing agent is a substance which gives hydrogen or gain oxygen. So that is the one, that is the, there is a difference. Let us see these terms in a practical, more practical way with the equations. Now first one is that oxidation or reduction reaction in terms of loss or gain of oxygen. In terms of loss or gain of oxygen, first reaction is that reaction of copper to oxide with hydrogen gas. Now if we write it, we'll write it like this: CuO solid will combine with hydrogen and will provide Cu plus H2O is there, right? So there are two reactants, CuO and H2O, that is converted to the product Cu and H2O. If you see in this whole equation, you will find that copper oxide will convert into copper on the product side, okay? Whereas hydrogen, that will be converted into H2O on the product side. This means copper oxide has changed to copper by loss of oxygen. It has lost its one oxygen present with it. That is why this is known as a reduction process. Loss of oxygen is shown here, therefore it's a reduction process. Whereas what hydrogen is converted to H2O by gain of one oxygen along with it. So product has accepted one electron, one oxygen. That's why this is a gain of oxygen and the process is called as oxidation. So clear indication is by the gain or loss of oxygen. Wherever, whenever you see that from reactant to product there is addition of oxygen, it is oxidation. And from reactant to product there is loss of oxygen, it is a reduction process. Okay. Now one thing I would like to tell you here is that next four terms we are going to discuss about it, further about it, that is an oxidizing agent or a substance reduced or reducing agent, as we have discussed. A very simple thing I would like to tell you here is that now this is a reduction process from copper oxide to copper. Now this copper oxide will be called as a substance reduced or oxidizing agent. So two names will be given to copper oxide. You need not to go to the product side for all the terms. You will stay toward the reactant only. So copper oxide, since it is showing reduction, copper oxide is the substance reduced, as well as it is also known as oxidizing agent. I'll tell you how. But keep in mind that whenever a part which is showing reduction, the substance from which reduction starts is the substance reduced or oxidizing agent. And the another reactant from which oxidation starts is a substance oxidized, or it is also called as reducing agent, right? So copper oxide will be substance reduced or oxidizing agent, whereas hydrogen will be substance oxidized or reducing agent. So same thing will happen with other equations also. Now this copper oxide is called as an oxidizing agent. Reason is because it gives this oxygen to hydrogen, so that the product will be copper, and this oxygen is taken by hydrogen and converted to water. Okay, so that's why it is known as an oxidizing agent. Whereas water, hydrogen has accepted this oxygen. That's why it is called as a reducing agent. So it is very clear that reduction, you have to identify first what is oxidation and where is reduction occurring and where is oxidation occurring. After that, the four things you can easily identify with it. Now, next one is that some more examples I'm giving you with the loss or gain of oxygen here. Fe3O4, iron oxide plus 4 hydrogen will convert to 3 Fe plus 4 H2O, right? Now, in this case, we have 2 reactant and 2 product. If you see here, Fe3O4 on the left-hand side, reactant side, whereas Fe will be formed on the product side. Now Fe3O4 will be converted to Fe on the product side by loss of these 4 oxygen, right? Now this removal of oxygen and Fe will be formed. Such a process is reduction. Okay, whereas if you see here, 4H2O is getting converted into 4H2O. Now in this case, oxygen is added on the product side. On reactant side, there was no oxygen, but on the product side, oxygen is being added here. This means there is addition of oxygen, and such a process is called as oxidation. This means, what do you call such a the substances? Substance reduced. Fe3O4, since reduction is occurring here, starting from here, that's why it is a substance reduced. It is also known as oxidizing agent. Whereas 4H2, from where addition of oxygen is occurring, that's why, or oxidation occurring, that's why it is called as substance oxidized or reducing agent. Now coming to the next one, as you can see here, I have also written here, substance oxidized is H2 or reducing agent is H2. Substance reduced is Fe3O4, whereas oxidizing agent is Fe3O4. It is very much clear from here. Now coming to the next one, second is that this oxidation and reduction can also be in terms of loss or gain of hydrogen. Earlier we have discussed about gain or loss of oxygen. Now we will talk about gain or loss of hydrogen. You have to see where there is gain of hydrogen or loss of hydrogen. When there is gain of, you see, gain of hydrogen, from the reactant to the product side, there is gain of hydrogen, it is always reduction. And if you see loss of hydrogen, it is oxidation. Now let us see this reaction. H2S changes to plus Cl2, changes to S plus 2HCl. If you see here, H2S is changing on the product side into S. Into S. But what is the change between them is the loss of this hydrogen molecule. H2 is lost in it. So removal of hydrogen is seen here. We call it as oxidation, right? Whereas if you see here Cl2, now this Cl2 will be converted into 2HCl. So if you see here, Cl2 is changes to HCl, and there is change of addition of this, there is addition of these two hydrogen atoms here. Addition of hydrogen mean reduction is seen here. Okay. Now in this reaction, once you identify which is an oxidation and which is a reduction, your half work is done. Now you will be easily able to identify which is the substance oxidized or substance reduced or reducing agent and oxidizing agent. Since oxidation is occurring here starting from H2S, so our substance oxidized will be H2S, right? Or you can also call it as reducing agent. H2S is reducing agent since it is providing hydrogen to chlorine, so that HCl can be converted into, that's why it's a reducing agent. Whereas Cl2, from which reduction is occurring, this is called a substance reduced, or we also call it as oxidizing agent. I hope you are able to understand it. Now next one is that similarly we take another example of MnO2 manganese dioxide plus 4HCl is there, that is getting converted to MnCl2 plus 2H2O plus Cl2 is there. Now if you see here, this HCl is getting converted to Cl2, right? What is the change? Loss of hydrogen. These four hydrogen are lost while conversion is made. Now in this case, the loss of hydrogen is oxidation. This means the other one, that is MnO2 to MnCl, is formed. This is a reduction process is there, because wherever there is oxidation, there will be reduction. So you need to identify only one part, the other part will be done with you. Now if these two are identified, these four terms can easily be coined by you, they can easily be recognized by you. Therefore the substance oxidized will be HCl, or it is also called as reducing agent. Whereas MnO2, from where reduction is starting, this is called as substance reduced, or it is also called as oxidizing agent. Okay, so what you need to do is you need to identify only where is reduction or oxidation is occurring, and you should also be able to identify whether there is a loss of oxygen or gain of oxygen, or hydrogen loss or gain is seen here. Then you will be able to do that. Now next one is oxidation or reduction in terms of loss or gain of electrons. Electron or ki gain ya loss se bhi hume oxidation reduction ka pata chalta hai. Oxidation is loss of electron, whereas reduction is gain of electrons, right? Loss of electron, wherever you see that there is magnesium is changes to magnesium 2 plus, that is loss of electron. By loss of electron, that is oxidation is occurring there. And if you see a gain of electron in any atom, that is a reduction. Let us see examples in it. I am giving you this example of 2Mg plus O2, that is getting converted into 2MgO. Okay. Now by this way, you won't be able to identify. You will say that where is the fourth product? I am unable to identify since fourth product is not there. But there is no need of it. Now look here. What I am writing here is Mg2+. Ions are in this MgO. Ions are Mg2+ and O2-. Okay. Now this magnesium, which is getting converted into Mg2+. Right. This is by loss of 2 electron. Because magnesium does not have any charge. It doesn't have any charge. But after the change, by loss of 2 electron, it has gained 2+ charge. Now, if this is so, this is called as oxidation reaction. Okay. On the other hand, this oxygen, which does not have any charge, is getting changed to the oxide, that is O2- by gain of 2 electron. 2- charge always comes by gain of 2 electrons. Okay. So, such a process is called as reduction. So, can you identify? I hope you will be able to identify which is the oxidizing agent or reducing agent, substance reduced or substance oxidized. Please try to solve it yourself, okay, in your notebook. Similarly, we take another one, that is Fe, iron plus sulfur is there. They are combining together and will change into FeS. Now, in this case, Fe is an atom. Sulfur is another atom. Whereas FeS is getting converted into Fe2+ and S2-. Okay. Fe2+ and S2- is there. Now in this case, this Fe is getting converted into Fe2+. by the loss of 2 electrons. So this means this is an oxidation process. Whereas sulfur which does not have any charge is getting converted to S2 minus by gain of 2 electrons. When there is excess of electron only, then minus charge occurs. So gain of 2 electron will make it S2 minus. So this is reduction. This means the substance from which reduction is starting is sulfur. This is called as substance reduced, or it is also called as oxidizing agent. Whereas Fe, from which oxidation starts, this is called substance oxidized or reducing agent, right? Now coming to the third one, that is zinc plus copper sulfate changes to zinc sulfate and copper. Now in this case, if we take an electronic form of it, we'll see this will be converted to Zn plus CuSO4. In CuSO4, copper is in 2 plus state. And in zinc ZnSO4, it is in Zn 2 plus state. Plus copper is there. Okay. Now this means that zinc is getting converted into zinc 2 plus here. Instead of writing ZnSO4, we are writing here Zn 2 plus. And here, instead of writing copper sulfate, we are writing its ionic form only, that is Cu2 plus. This Cu2 plus is getting converted to copper. Okay. Now, after putting this ionic equation, let us see. This zinc, first of all, getting converted into Zn2 plus by loss of 2 electrons. Okay. So, such a state is called as oxidation. Whereas Cu2 plus is getting converted into Cu atom back by gain of 2 electrons, which is called as reduction. So you will be able to identify which is the reducing agent. Reducing agent in this case is zinc, whereas oxidizing agent is Cu2+. Now coming to the next one. So I hope you'll be able to identify all the terms here. All above reactions are redox reactions, because in each reaction, oxidation and reduction reaction take place simultaneously. Students, I am giving you an assignment with 3 questions, in which first question you have to identify a reducing agent. Okay, first is 4NH3 plus 5O2 will give 4NO plus 6H2O. Now this NH3 is getting converted into NO, whereas this O2 is getting converted into H2O. So try to solve it yourself. This one also convert. So try to solve this question at your own level, and if you feel any difficulty, find any difficulty, you can ask me. Second is identify the oxidizing agent or oxidant in the following reaction. Again, oxidizing agent mean the substance which is getting reduced. So you have to find out which one is getting reduced out of it. That is only possible when you solve it completely, by where the oxidation is occurring or where reduction is occurring. So do it for yourself, all the things, and find out which is the oxidizing agent in it. Now next one is balance the following chemical equations and identify the substance reduced, substance oxidized, reducing agent or oxidizing agent out of them. So I'm giving you these equations. Now in first equation, convert it into ionic form, then you will be able to get it. Here you can convert to ionic form, then ionic form, you will convert it. Okay, so you know about valency of all the atoms, you can easily convert them into ionic form here. And then I make a oxidation and reduction statement, and then put all these, find out all the terms out of them. Students, along with this, I'm giving you a very short video on Oilrig. Find out what Oilrig is. Oilrig, that is
the second part of the second segment of the video. And in this segment, I'm going to tell you a very effective trick in order to determine which of the following reactants in a particular reaction is oxidizing or which is getting reduced. So the rule is called Oilrig. By O we mean oxidation, I stands for is, L stands for loss of electrons, R stands for reduction, I again for is, and G stands for gain of electrons. So this is a very simple rule that helps us to determine which of the following species or which of the following reactants is getting oxidized or reduced. So taking an example, for example, we have copper oxide plus H2, which gives us Cu plus H2O. This is the reaction that was seen, also seen in the first part of the video. So first of all, we have to write the ionic equation. By ionic equation, I mean that we have to write the charges that are present on the atoms or individual atoms that are present in a particular molecule. So as we know that oxygen is highly electronegative, therefore almost in all of its compounds, we can say it has a net charge of -2. So as the whole molecule is neutral, there should be a +2 here. So we have a copper +2 charge. And there is a rule that when an atom is present in its free state, for example, it is not combined with any atom of other species. For example, copper is alone here, not with oxygen or any other. Cu is not with any other. So therefore, it will have an oxidation state or a charge of 0. Similarly, hydrogen H2 gas will be of 0. Here we know that oxygen is again of -2. So let us calculate the valency or the charge of H. So let it be X. As we know that the whole molecule is neutral, we get 2X minus 2 equals to 0. Therefore, X should be 1. So it is in +1 charge. Now the reaction ionic, in the ionic form, we can write it as Cu plus 2 plus H2 gives us Cu plus H plus. Now balance it. 2H plus. It is balanced both ways in ionic as well as in the analytical form. So as we know, as we see that this is changing from +2 to 0 oxidation state. This means that we have to give it 2 electrons. So we are giving it, or it is gaining 2 electrons. So as we know that by gain of electrons, it is getting reduced. Similarly, it is going from 0 to +1. It is losing electrons. So when it is losing electrons, it is getting oxidized in nature. So we know that H2 is getting oxidized and CuO is getting reduced in this particular reaction. This is a very simple rule and can be applied in very various complex reactions and almost all the reactions that are present in your textbook. So I prefer that you go and check them out and try them yourself. And after, in your exams, you have to write it in this way, that the oxidized substance is H2. The reduced substance is CuO. The reducing agent is again H2, and the oxidizing agent is again CuO.